Hi again everyone. This is a video lecture for Chapter 2 Kinematics. This video is divided into three parts. This is an introductions video, followed by lecture on motion in one dimension, and the third part is lecture on motion in two dimensions. As an introduction, I think it is better if we first understand the origins of kinematics. Kinematics is actually one from two parts of mechanics physics. Now, what is mechanics physics? As you can see over here, mechanics is the branch of physics that focuses on the motions of the object and the forces that cause the motions to change. For example, when person A pushes a box, this box will experience motions. These motions will happen due to some forces from person A. So from the motions of the box, the forces cause the motions, all of this will be studied in mechanics, physics. So, as I said earlier, there are two parts of mechanics. The first one is kinematic, which is this chapter, and the second one is dynamic. Now, kinematics is dealing with the concepts that are needed to describe motions without care about the forces. So when the box moves from this point to this point, what will be the initial speed of it? How far will the box move from the initial position to the final positions? And what will be the accelerations of the person A to pushes this box? All of this will be discussed in kinematics. While in dynamics, which you will learn in chapter 4, is dealing with the effect the motions, the force that forces have on motions. So what type of energy that had been transferred from person A to the box when she or he pushes it? What forces that act opposing the directions of this box? All of this is in dynamics. Now in kinematics, we will be looking at the kinematics in one dimensions, which means motion along straight line, which motions that involve the concept of displacement, velocity, acceleration, and free fall. While at kinematics in two dimensions, we will learn on motion that involves in projectile motions. This is the learning outcome of these chapters. I will leave it to you reading. Just take note that when you achieve all of these learning outcome, then that means you understand this chapter. And this is the outline of this chapter. As I said earlier, my second video will be on the motion in one dimension, and my third video will be about motions in two dimensions. So keep watching with my next video for you to be able writing and or drawing your mind map of this chapter.